Well, hi, this is Jay Arthur, and I'd like to tell you an improvement story using value stream mapping. Well, I worked with this one computer operations group, and they actually ran batch jobs over the evening so that their online systems could come up in the morning on these big IBM mainframes. And they were having a problem because they couldn't seem to get their overnight batch processing done in time to bring up the onlines in the morning. Well, guess what? You know, the 9,000 service reps were waiting on those onlines to come up in the morning. They thought they were going to have to buy another mainframe computer to handle all of the load. And so what we did was just kind of slowed it down, and with value stream mapping, the great thing about it is you're actually slowing down the process so that people can look at it and go, hey, that's stupid. All right? And so I want to introduce you to your two advanced technologies for Lean. Post-it notes, right? I use the little rectangular ones for activities and arrows for the delays between things. I also use these, turn them on a side as a decision, that's our decision point. All right, so pretty easy process. So essentially what was happening was they would run a job and then they'd have somebody, technician in the middle of the night, decide whether it should continue. And if it should continue, well, that's a great thing. So they'd run the next job, and then they'd decide again, right? So they'd have to check the return codes, make sure everything ran right. Then they'd take that, and they'd run another job, and so on. And so what we were doing in here is we found that there was, you know, in terms of running a job, deciding, running a job, deciding, running a job, deciding, in between the finish of a job and the decision point, they were waiting on a technician for maybe up to 15 minutes. And they had 32 decision points in their nightly run. Well, you can tell 15 minutes, 32, you're going to end up running 9 hours, right? Just on pure technician time alone. And so what we did, you start to look in here, it doesn't take that long to run a job. But if you're doing 15 minutes here and 15 minutes here and 15 minutes after every job, it doesn't take long for your run times to speed up and take too long. And so what they did was they said, you know, I wonder, I think the operating system can figure out if the return code from this job is okay, make that decision for us and kick off the next job. And so out of 32 decision points, what did they do? They found that 30 of them could be done by the computer. And two of them really needed a technician to check on it. And so when you get rid of all of these decision points that were in there, except for a couple, guess what? They found out that they could run their nightly batch processing in 1 hour. Not 9 hours like they were running before, but 1 hour. And this is not unusual. All right, when you get rid of all the delays between steps, it's not unusual to take a cycle time that's 9 hours and cut it to 1 hour. 9 days, cut it to 1 day. 90 days, cut it to, you know, maybe 10 days or less. It does not take that long because the issue is all of the cycle time is in the delays between steps and decisions and so on. And you probably know this from decision-making processes in your business, right? You know, if you have to send it out and get somebody to approve something, guess what? It takes too long because it goes out there, it sits in their inbox, and eventually they get around to reading it and making a decision, and then they send it back to you. But it's 2 or 3 days, and all of that iterative cycle time in there is taking too long. So the question is, how can we automate those decisions? Make them yes, no, right? Not everything has to be approved by everybody all the time. You know, probably 4% of the decisions need special attention, and the other 96, you can just kind of go, okay, it's within bounds. I did the same thing with a customer service rep in a credit union. I mean, they found that it was taking too long to get approvals, and so people were backing up in line. And so they just extended the credit limits that they could approve things for at the window, and all of a sudden, their cycle time started speeding up, and they got people through the line in the credit union more quickly. Decision-making and the delays to make that decision sometimes are one of the biggest wastes in any process. So anyway, I hope this gives you an idea about how we take even an IT process, a nightly batch process, and slow it down, figure out what's going on, and figure out how to fix it through automation or handing the decision-making off to some other place or freeing people up to make it easier. And that's how easy it can be to use these simple tools to find ways to cut 80-90% out of your cycle time. Just using a team meeting for a couple hours, bing, out comes the answer. Thanks.